Hello, my friends. I'm so glad that you've joined us again today for Nuggets at Noon. We've had a wonderful weekend here in Woodruff, South Carolina. I'm with my close friend, Sergei Zaitsev. He was one of my students in Moscow. And this is his son, Ruslan. And so we've just had a great time. And today I'm just going to talk with them and let them meet you and share some of their testimonies. And so, Sergei, what year did you come to America?
I came to America in
1999. Okay. And Ruslan, how old were you when you
came? I was about 12 years old.
12?
Yes, 12 years old when I came here.
Okay.
To the United States, and of course it was a cultural shock, not knowing the language and not be able to understand what people talk around you or speak around you.
So, well, you do very well with your English. Yeah. I mean, so you went to an English speaking school?
Or? Yes, yes. I finished from grade 6, I believe, from grade 6 to all the way to 12, and basically was raised half my life in United States.
Now, you all, when you first came to Pennsylvania, is that correct?
Yes, we started in Pennsylvania. Then my parents actually migrated to South Carolina in 2007 or 2008.
Yeah. Okay, and Sergei, so you have 8 children, correct? And how many boys, how many girls?
Yes, when I came to America, it was 8 children in my family, and my wife, Beauty. And 6 boys and 2 girls.
6 boys and 2 girls. Now, we were talking some last night, and y'all really, you had nothing when you came. You were just totally, just came with just what you could bring in suitcases and everything. Is that
correct?
Yes.
Yes. We was invited by my wife's sister to America, and she said, don't take anything. We take care about you. God will provide you. And we take it some basic stuff with our towels, maybe clothes a little bit. And also I borrow from my friend $50 mm-hmm. in case if there will be not enough food here, I can feed my children $50.
But you know, last night, and this is kind of what I wanted to share with you today, I was chatting with Sergei and his wife last night, and they were talking about when they were in Russia, how they gave and gave of their home and gave of their time to ministry. He started a church. The School of Christ, of course, was training pastors to start churches, and he had started a church, and they just poured their life into the ministry there. But when they came to America, they had nothing. But because of their giving, their sacrificial giving in Russia, that God just turned around and blessed them. And they, now even though they came with nothing, God has now provided him with a great business. And Ruslan works for his dad here in the business of what is it, electrical work?
Electrical, yes.
Electrical
business.
Yeah.
Subcontracting for companies.
So basically, we are a staffing company. We staff electricians, HVAC, and plumbers. Mm. So we provide contractors, helpers in time of need.
Wow. And you're married and have two children?
I have 2 children, a beautiful wife. My 2 daughters are 12. Actually 13 and 8.
Well, you get that right.
Yeah.
She wouldn't appreciate that. 13 and 8. Okay. And but God has blessed you. And there's a principle in that. If you give, and I believe this is what God wants us to do. He pours into us and we pour out. And you did that in those early days in Russia, and you're still doing that. You are still, God is blessing you, and you too, Ruslan. And I've seen just by looking around in the ministries you've been involved in, that you are still liberal in your giving, and God designed it that way. He blesses us to be a blessing. And it's so exciting to be with you, and I'm excited what God's going to do through your church there in Woodruff, South Carolina. But I want to just close with a song. Sergei plays the accordion. Now we don't have accordions. We don't hear much accordions anymore, do
we? Not at all.
But I'm going to close today with just a song. Sergei, would you pick your accordion up and let's Here now, you don't play the accordion, do you?
No.
You do play the guitar, though.
I used to carry a guitar for my dad.
Oh, you carried the guitar for your dad? Well, I was a gopher for my dad for a lot of things, you know, but in his business and so on. But you were a gopher for him.
Exactly. That's what I used to do when I was a child.
Yeah. All right, give us a song.
This is a Russian song.
So a Russian song. Okay, yeah. That's okay. We'll go ahead.
We'll enjoy it.
We'll enjoy it.
Carry your light.
Carry your light.
Yeah, in this world. Yes.
Okay. All right. Play it for us.
Yes. Христианин, неси огонь чудесный свой, который дал тебе Христос. Он умер на кресте, пожертвовал собой. Огонь любви он всем принес. Гори, огонь, всегда гори. Воспламеняй собой холодные сердца и новый мир прекрасный озари, которому радость без конца, которому радость без конца. Вот путь он только стал призывом пути. Согрей его и ободри. Скажи, что нет пути, тебе вечный Бог. Засветит солнце впереди. Гори огонь, всегда гори. Воспламеняй с собой холодные сердца. И новый мир прекрасный озари, которому радость без конца, которому радость без конца. All right, beautiful guys. Thank you so much. I love that. And I want to ask my watchers, if you would, to keep these guys in your prayers. They've got a great thing going at the church, but they need God's wisdom and guidance to see things go forward. And so if you would just pray for Sergey and Ruslan Zaitsev. And thank you so much, guys, for joining me today. God bless you. We'll look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Bye-bye. Thank you.